Toy Staff Nation, we are back here. This time we are at UTSA at the Cathedral, at their hometown with Coach Derek Pittman. Epic game we just got to see today. Two straight wins. Conference in play already. Another third conference game coming on Sunday. It's going to be senior day, so we're going to be definitely going to be watching you. Tell me, two scores, two goals from Deja. Yep. Amazing goal player here. And then your goalkeeper, Jill. Phenomenal. Let's just be nitty gritty to the T. 2-1 to UTSA. It could have been a 2-2. Jill stopped one. That could have been pretty bad for you guys. But the girls played on top at Temple. Deja was on fire today. Two goals for the young lady. Coach, talk to me.
Well, first of all, Southern Miss came out in a different shape than they'd played all season. They've been playing a 4-3-3 and switched to a kind of a 5-2-3 on us. So it took us a couple minutes to kind of adjust and figure out where the spaces were going to be and what we had been preparing on such a short week. But I thought our players adjusted very well. Obviously, it was great to get. We talk about set pieces a ton. In fact, for over half an hour yesterday, we worked on set pieces. And not only defending them, but attacking them. And we know that Kendall Close, Deja Sandoval, Nicole Gallon, they're all very, very good in the air. And we try to run different sets that be able to get them free. And Ellis served a great ball in for the first one. And then the second was a little bit of a scramble, but she stayed in it. And we talk about just keep it alive, you know, just keep selling out. And she did exactly that to be able to put that over the edge. And then, absolutely, our goalkeeper, Jill, did a great job. I thought a whole back line. We learned a lot from some of the heartbreak losses that we've had, how to close games out. I thought we did a good job of that, or a better job of that against Marshall, but then a really, really good job closing out the game tonight. And so really proud of our players and the step forward they took today.
It was a little bit of rough patch throughout the season up to this point. Now, I want to talk a little bit more about those fast improvements you've done on the backfield. I know it's been an Achilles heel all season. Today, a complete different defense, a complete different midfield. Guide us a little bit as to what your thought process was, how to improve that, how to make it better, especially right now making it forward into conference play.
Well, we got back a little bit this past couple weeks, to be honest with you, a little bit more. We've been focused on our identity. Really what made us great last year, what we built this team on from the beginning, was how we defend, how we structure ourselves, how we organize ourselves to be able to limit teams' chances. And I thought we've done that over the last couple games very, very well. Again, we've given up some goals, but I thought, again, even looking back to how we handled Rice, how we handled North Texas, I thought we were very, very good. We held Florida Atlantic, basically with no goals, basically until the 80th minute. So we did a lot of really, really good things, just kind of focusing and training. Serena Russ went down with an injury, and Katie Ann Lochte has absolutely stepped up and owned the defensive midfield role. Deja, Kendall, you talk about center back pairings that are just growing, and they're doing an excellent job. And then to be able to have Alex Granville to come off the bench and be able to help Cameron Hoover and Sarah Bahi so that they don't have to carry the whole load, it really frees us up to be able to have fresh legs as much as possible. And again, our goalkeeping play continues. I mean, Sophie Millich was great in the early parts of the season. Jill has been great as of late. And again, so the total team effort, and obviously now we're scoring some goals. And so even when Ellis and Lexi and Abby aren't scoring goals, we're dangerous on set pieces.
Absolutely.
And putting ourselves in a position to get 3 points, which we did tonight.
And now you don't have to rely on just two forward strikers. Now you got your midfielders doing work, and now you got your defenders doing the work. Folks, Coach Derek Pittman, check him out here on Sunday. It is going to be senior night. It's going to be awesome. We're going to be out here. They're going to have all the players' numbers on the field. Coach, great job. Best of luck to you on Sunday. We'll be seeing you guys on Sunday.
Awesome. Thank you.
Not only with the player of the game, let me tell you a little bit about Deja Sandoval. Two goals tonight against Southern Miss. Ms. Deja, what was going on? Tell me, talk to me about these two goals. How you feeling? You guys are coming off a little bit of a tough patch. You guys girls come back home. You're on a two-game winning streak. Talk to me. Two goals tonight.
We're just super excited to get this win. We've been working really hard in practice, and it's finally paying off.
And so the first goal that Heather you had, I mean, talking got to me, that one, I was pretty sick.
It was cool. I saw the ball coming in, and I kind of just like moved my head, and next thing I know, I was in the back of the net.
There you go. Back of the net. She's got four goals all season. She's got her two tonight. Young lady, the freshman representing the Roadrunners out of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Congratulations. Heck of a game.
Thank you.
Do not forget the Sunday. You want to tell people to come out and see us Sunday?
Yes, come out and see us Sunday. We play at 7 p.m.
Yes.
Go Runners.
Yeah, senior night. Go Runners. You guys crushed it. You girls have been playing phenomenal soccer. Guide me through it. I mean, you have come down from losing a couple games. You come back home. You're crushing it. You're on a two-game winning streak. Abby, talk to me. What's going on with you girls? What's the potion?
Well, I think it's been great because we've had a lot of close games all season. Every loss we've had has been by one goal. So it's finally been awesome to be on the other end of that and winning these close games. This game especially was really important to us because we held it out. We got a goal early in the second half, and we had to hold it out for the last 20 minutes or so, which we've struggled with in the past. So we're growing. We're doing better every game, and excited to keep going.
Guide me through the last 5 minutes. You said you girls have been struggling. Every game that we've been watching online has been going down to the minute. Today was a completely different UTSA Runners game. You girls came out, managed it very well. Guide me through that last minute. I know you were out there. What were you doing? We saw you on the side pitch. What was the mentality at that time?
Well, we really just wanted to key in our focus, make sure we had the same focus that we started the game with, because obviously any minute of the game, anything can happen. We've experienced that. Getting in on every single tackle. We had some really important moments from our defense. We had Kendall, a great header from the clearance. We had Cam read a great through ball to not let it in behind. And in the last 10 seconds, Alex made an awesome tackle on the sideline to make sure that the ball didn't get played over the top, which are things we have been missing in the past, and we just put it all out there. We like to say full throttle, like go through it, and we did that in the last 5 minutes. That's why we got the win.
Full throttle, and that's the way the girls have been playing. Come watch them on Sunday as they defend another conference game. It is going to be a match senior night. We'll be seeing you guys, folks.
Thank you.
What exactly is it that they do?
Kick names, take ass.